Now we're going to learn about how to determine if a series converges or diverges. So our example is here. We're doing a series from n to equals 0 to infinity of these terms here. So we're going to think about comparing it to a p series, one of those 1 over n to the p type. And this one looks like 1 over n to the 1 half, 1 over square root of n. It looks like those terms are looking like that. So all we have to do is maneuver our terms to be greater than these terms to show that our series diverges. So we start off with our inequality. We start with our term, and we want to maneuver it toward the 1 over the square root of n. So I can't take the square root of 2 plus n. I'm kind of stuck there. But if I up the 2 up to an n itself, I can then add the n's together, and good things will happen. So I write this as my habit. I write the little less than or equal to on the denominator because I want my second denominator to be greater than my first one if I expect my second fraction to be less than my first. But in the numerator, it matches up. If I want my first fraction to be greater than or equal to the second, then I want my numerator to be greater than or equal to the numerator of the second. So in the denominator, it's just reversed. So definitely 2 is less than or equal to n as long as n is greater than or equal to 2. So as long as this is preserved, then I have that this inequality holds, and of course that's equal to 1 over the square root of 2n, which is square root of 2 over 2, rationalizing the denominator, 1 over square root of n. So now I'm here. So back to our series, I want to compare it against this series here, but that series is going to only be good for n greater than or equal to 2, so I have to burn off a couple of terms of my series so that it'll start at 2 and start instead of back at 0. So when n equals 0, I plug in for 0 and I get 2 over the square root of 2. That's where that term came from. N equals 1 is the next one. That's 2 over the square root of 3. Then I add on the rest, which is this series here. And that's greater than or equal to this sum, because all I did was rationalize the denominator to get to this term, rationalize this one. So those are two terms are equal. And then I already showed from a chain of inequalities that this series is less than ours. In other words, our series is greater than this one, okay? Greater than or equal to. And of course, then that simplifies down. All they did was take this and factor it out of the sum and put it here. So now I've established that inequality, that our series is greater than or equal to this sum, which includes this series. Now we already know that 1 over square root of n from 1 to infinity diverges because the exponent on the n is a half, and a half is less than or equal to 1. So that's known. So all I have to do is maneuver my 1 over square root of n, 1 to infinity, to burn off one term and start it here at 2 so that everything will match up. Okay, so I have n equals 1, that's 1, and then the rest of it is here. So, since these two are equal, these two sums, then this part must diverge. We already know that this part does. This diverges. So this whole thing diverges. Well, 1 is just a number. That means the rest of it has to diverge, because if it converged, And then when I added on the 1, that would converge, and that would contradict that this series here diverges. Okay, and that implies that if I just multiply that divergent series by a constant, square root of 2 over 2, that will diverge also. Of course, I got the idea for the square root of 2 over 2 to put that there because I know I'm going to have to match it up to this later. So then that implies that if this series diverges and I just add on a couple of constants, of course that whole series with those two terms added on, that diverges also. So from earlier, we had that our original series was greater than or equal to this sum right here, and that's exactly what is written here. And we already just said that this sum plus that series diverges, and so what this line right there says is that our original problem, our series, is greater than a series that diverges. Therefore, our original series diverges.